Hi everybody. I'm going to give you a tour today of how to enroll in MyMathLab and just show you around to see a few things. I'm in a browser window. I'm actually using Mozilla Firefox. I kind of like Mozilla better than other browsers, especially when using MyMathLab. If you have a personal computer, you can download it. Go to www.mozilla.org, and I really recommend it. It's a good one. Let's go to right now www.mymathlab.com. I've been there a few times, so it came up automatically for me. And I'm going to show you how to register. So if you're a brand new student, we'll click down here. And you need three things, really only two. Let me explain why. You'll need an email address, and it can be your Citrus College email or it can be your personal email. I actually prefer your personal email for this because it gives me another lifeline to you. So if that's possible, use your Yahoo, your Google, your Gmail, whatever email you have. Second, what you need is a course ID. Our course ID will be specific to our course for this certain semester that I'm teaching the course. I'll be using a certain course ID for this demo. Please check your syllabus, though, to make sure your course ID is the correct one for your course. You don't need a credit card or an access code yet. Every student gets a two-week free trial of our MyMathLab. But if you do have an access code, and how would you have it? If you purchase the textbook bundle from our Citrus College OWL Bookshop. If you have that paper textbook, it comes with an access code for MyMathLab. So you can, at the end of this demo, you would be able to type in your access code, and then you're all done. You're registered. You don't need the two-week free trial. But for those of you who haven't purchased anything yet, I'll show you some of the options that you have. All right, let's register now. The first thing it will ask you for is your course ID. The course ID starts with my name, Dominguez, D-O-M-I-N-G-U-E-Z, 63738 is the course ID I'm using for this demo, but it will probably be different for you if you're taking this course at a later date than fall 2017. So check your syllabus before you do anything. Click on continue. If you don't have a Pearson account, you can create one. I'm actually going to do that. I don't have one with a certain username that I have, victoria.dominguez@gmail.com. And I can let that be my username. And then I will need to create a password. So let me think about this. It has to have at least 8 characters, one number, one letter, one capital letter. And do not use your name or username, and do not use spaces or special characters other than the underscore, the at sign, a period, or a dash. Those are the only special characters that are allowed. So let me make up something here. And let me retype it. Hopefully I got the same one. Looks good. All right. So I'm typing in my first name, my last name, my security question. I'm just choosing one. I won't use this account, so don't tell anybody my security question. I accept the license agreement, and that's good enough. Click on create account. Up here, you can click on save. That's fine. What Firefox will do for you is to save your login. That's handy, because if you can't remember the password, it will put it in for you. So I usually do click on save here. So see, now here is the course. Again, this demo is for the fall 2017 course, Math 140 Distance Education. And that course ID is specifically tied to that course. But your screen will look very similar if you are taking this class at a later date. Here's where you would put your access code in if you are purchasing the textbook bundle. The access code, by the way, is a piece of cardboard. It looks a little strange because you think, well, where's this code? Open it, just open the piece of cardboard, and inside you'll see a code. Let me click over there so you can see how the code would look. So it's six different words, kind of weird. Some are words, some are just characters, character combinations. And that's what they're looking for you to enter here in these boxes. I'm going to click on back. I hope it will take me back, and it did. Another way you can do this right now, you could buy my math lab, just buying the homework and the e-text. So everybody gets a ebook, no matter which way you purchase the homework system, either by buying the textbook bundle that comes with the access code or purchasing it using a credit card online, or you can use PayPal. The third way for now, though, I want to alert you to is this one at the bottom where it says get temporary access without payment for 14 days. So if you click on that, then it means that yes, you want temporary access, and you'll be able to do everything in my math lab that you need to for the first 2 weeks. You can't re-access this with another email address, by the way, because I will delete that account. But it gives you a little time to get going. So let's click on yes and give it a minute. And there we go. So I'm going to click on go to my courses, and it will take you to our class.